sitting comfortable on the mat, if you prefer, if you don't feel comfortable sitting on the mat, you can use your pillows, your cushions, yeah? If you need to extend the legs, go ahead. Yeah, just sitting then, nice and comfy. Go. Have your everything around you, should, so you don't have to move too much. Yeah, you have your pillows, your blankets, your socks, everything that you need. Go. Well done. And just start to settle on the mat or on the cushions with your hips. Don't worry too much about the posture. Just settle there. I want you to have a little bit of reminder that even when we are during our day sitting probably at home these days, doing your work or just whatever you do at home, that we still can arrive to that center inside us where there is peace and where is grounding and where is a beautiful energy. So that sometimes we don't have time during the day to lying down, but you still can recover that sensation of being in tune with yourself, with your body, with your breathing, yeah? So just sitting there and place, if you like, your hands on your heart or on your belly, or one hand on your belly and one on your heart. If you need to move the legs, move it, eh? Don't worry. And just feel your hands on your body there and feel the movement of your breathing into your belly, on the chest. Maybe you can feel the beat of your heart as well, or hear it. And just be there for a moment with that sensation, with that movement. You don't have to force anything, just connect. If you can, maybe you can start to breathe in through your nose, if it's possible. At least the breathing, yeah? So we can engage the energy of the nostrils, yeah? We have center of energy on the nostrils. And when you breathe out, just surrender to the floor. Don't worry too much about the posture, yeah? Just breathe in. And then when you breathe out, release, surrender. Imagine that you want to go closer and closer to the floor with your hips, with your legs. Yeah, so a nice breathe in. Ah, breathe out and let go. And imagine when you breathe in now, you are absorbing from above a beautiful violet energy or light that is coming through the crown of your head from really high above. Yeah, imagine from the ceiling or from outside, going into the crown of your head, entering into your body, but also you can imagine part of the energy going around your body like a shower. And imagine when you breathe in, you take that energy in, and when you breathe out, you let that light, that violet light or energy passing through around you and inside you. And imagine this light, this energy is cleansing yourself, cleansing your body, cleansing your mind from all the worries, all the things that could be bothering you. Yeah, imagine it's a total cleansing inside out. Total cleansing in the emotional aspect, on the physical aspect. And when you breathe out, imagine that you let go all of those worries, or anything that is bothering you into the floor. Yeah? And as you breathe out and you, as you release all that, imagine that you expand your roots. Or if you are working always, if you're doing the class always in the same spot in your house, you can imagine that that spot is already ready, the roots are ready to catch you. Yeah? So you sit in there and you are already connected with the roots, really high, connected with the planet, your roots, really deep, going into the center of the planet. Yeah? So breathe in, imagine that violet light going, passing through, cleansing your body. And when you breathe out, all that is going into the planet through the roots to be released. The planet, imagine, will take care of that for you. You don't have to worry anymore. Yeah? At least for a little bit. Yeah, at least during this class. So 2 or 3 breaths more with this idea of the violet light coming from above, passing through, surrender anything that you need to let go. You don't have to think what you need to let go, just breathe out and let go, release. Let the energy take care of you there. And now we will invert the process, yes? So now we will imagine that we will receive the energy from the planet through the roots. So imagine that in the breathing, you are absorbing the energy from the planet. And you can give it the color here that is coming to your mind, yeah? As a reminder, if you need more physical grounding or health support, or you know, you are worried about the financial aspect of our life, imagine a red light, yeah, bringing you everything that you need. Or if you need more support for the emotional body, an orange color coming from the planet, yeah, to embrace you, like giving you a beautiful hug of protection and understanding. If you need more energy, you can imagine the yellow into your solar plexus. If you need loving energy, pure loving energy, imagine the pink into your heart. If you need more energy or strength, you can imagine the turquoise to communicate more easily. And if you need to connect more with your ideas, with your intuition, with your wisdom, imagine an indigo color coming up. So any of those colors, or just breathe in and let the colors coming in. Don't worry. You will receive the one that you need. Yeah? So don't force any visualization. Just breathe in. And don't worry if you don't get any color. Just breathe in. You will receive anyway the action, the energy that you need and the benefit that you need, yeah? Good. And to finish this visualization, now imagine that when you breathe in, we will absorb both at the same time. So you will receive the energy from the planet and the energy of the violet light from above. And let those two energies meet wherever you need in your body or in your mind or in your heart. Yeah, so imagine breathing, absorbing both lights at the same time, and they meet in the spot that you need. Yeah, maybe in your belly for relaxation of your emotional body, or maybe on your solar plexus, or maybe on your heart or in your throat. Or maybe on your hips, your lower back. Yeah? So again, don't force a visualization. Just breathe in, taking all these energies in, and imagine that they arrive together and they form a beautiful, more strong energy to cleanse that area where they meet. And if you are not sure, just imagine that they meet in the center of your body, maybe your heart, or your solar plexus, and from there, this energy is like explode inside of you, cleansing even more, giving you everything and anything that you need in this present moment. So take 2 or 3 more of this breath. And remember that you can do this exercise at home whenever you need during the day. Yeah, just sitting like we are or in a chair, just connecting with your breathing and imagine this energy is working there. And in your next breathing, push, let this energy lifting into your spine. Yeah? So use that energy to expand now your spine, your chest, your neck. Yeah, imagine that this energy is pulling you up on the physical body. If you need to move the legs, you move it. Yeah? And we will take a nice breathing with your arms as well, lifting. Imagine that you help with your arms to lift in this energy up. And we will stretch side to side, nice and comfy. Not forcing it, sweet and comfortable. And then relax. And keep in that beautiful position of your spine there. We will twist a little bit, nice and gentle, don't force. Remember, if you need to move the legs, you move. So breathe in. Again, imagine absorbing those 2 energies. And imagine this energy is passing through your spine, cleansing all of your spine, all of your body, your heart, your mind. Move your head as well, as much back as you can without forcing it. And keeping the position, we will move only the head to the front, passing through the other side, to the other side, with your shoulders relaxing. And then back to the twist. And relax, well done. And then we lift in again on the center. Imagine breathing in, absorbing the energy with the root, from the root and from above. Yeah. Lifting your spine, your chest, your solar plexus, and we rotate to the other side. No force in the rotation, yeah. Nice and gentle. Every breathing, you pushing the hips into the floor or into the cushions. Imagine that with that pushing, you enhance or you engage more with those energies that you are lifting. And keeping the position, we bring the head, only the head, to the front and to the other side. And then back. Relax to the center. Well done. And the last bit here, we will move with your chest, with your upper body. Again, if you need, if you're not comfortable, you can open the legs, yeah? So don't worry. And move like a circus. And again, imagine that with this movement, you are like connecting even more with those energies. Yeah, imagine that you are creating that beautiful channel or conduit where the energy is passing through. We go to the other side. Imagine that you are connecting with the energies and you are starting to get the command of that energy, of those energies. Yeah? Well done, very nice, good. And then we soften the legs a little bit and we will go to all fours, yeah? So take your time, have your bolster or your pillows in front of your mat, or if you have blocks, you can put 2 blocks there, yeah? And we go to all fours. If you have problem with the knees, remember you can put your blanket or your pillows, yeah? Good. and we move the hips, there in circles. Yeah, nice and easy. Connecting with your breathing. So remember that every part of your body that is touching the floor, you are connecting with those roots. Yeah? So in this moment, your hands also are receiving the energy, your legs. And then the opposite direction. Well done. And then on the center, breathing and open arching here. So allow your spine here to arch, no forcing, just let like your belly soft and your bum is out, your head is up. Your shoulders are relaxing away from your ears. Yeah? So stay a little bit on the arching position just to let like your belly fall more. You are not forcing that, it's just you let go with the gravity. And then on your next breath out, you push into the hands and you round your back and bring your neck and your head down. And stay in this rounding position for a little bit as well. Bringing the chin toward the chest. Try not to constrict your shoulders. Yeah? Try to keep the shoulders away. And then we do these movements with your breathing. So when you breathe in, expanding open. When you breathe out, you round. Breathing open, expand. Breathe out, release. Go. One more time. And then we will do the same with the feet. So we will curl the toes. We'll press the back of the toes. Press your hands, arching your back, expanding open. And then breathe out and rounding. Breathing open, expand. Breathe out and rounding. Well, one more time. Breathing, expand. Remember, each breath in, you are receiving, and each breath out, you are letting go. And we will open the knees and we go to child pose. Yeah? So we will go back. Wherever is possible, don't force. You can put the hands on the front, or you can put the hands beneath your forehead. If you feel uncomfortable, you can put a cushion beneath your bum, between your bum and your feet, or beneath your feet. Yeah, nice and comfy. And again, let go. Yeah, so on the breath out, surrender to the floor. Let go completely. Imagine like you are now more closer to the roots, to the planet. So it's more easy for the planet to take care of you. And you can still imagine that violet light passing through from above. Like a shower now on your back, on your neck, on your hips, on your lower back. And then we move the hands to one side. Surrender. And then we go to the other side. And then come back to the center. We go to all fours. And we will bring one arm beneath the other arm. Yeah? So like this. So the shoulder on the floor, we put the head and we relax the other arm and we soften. If it's uncomfortable, you can put the pillow beneath your head and just, again, surrender to the floor. Use your breath out to let go, to release. So each part that we are moving, imagine that we are using the energy that you receive to cleanse all those spots. And then we change and we go to the other side. Surrender. Go and then come back. Good. Now we will do again, we will open the knees again and we will put the hands to over the bolster or the pillows or the blocks. We just need a little bit of height, yeah? Just to increase the opening of the chest. So we will put the arms in front, shoulders away from your ears. Go with your hips back. So try to go hips and then belly and then solar plexus and then your chest toward the floor. There is no forcing here, eh? Just wherever you can go to increase the opening of your chest, to open your heart, to open your breathing. And the receiving of the energy. Well done. Ah, relax. Well done. Now we will put the hands again on the floor and we will move a little bit the legs, shoulders away. We will arch again in a really soft way. Yeah? So arching and then rounding. Moving the head as well. So the head goes up and then rounding, go down. Open softly. And again. Imagine as you move, you are allowing your body to release and to recharge. The places that we release, now they have more space to receive energy. Yeah? And then we change, we go with the other leg, breathing, expanding, breathe out round. Breathing, expanding. And round. One more time. Good. And last one. Good. Well done. And we will go with one leg forward. Yeah, we will go to a standing position just for a little bit. Take your time. Yeah. And with the feet nice and comfy. Ground your feet, yeah? So try to open your toes. Let the knees soft, yeah? So relax. So don't push, yeah? Relax. And imagine your feet opening again to the visualization of the root and the receiving of energy, yeah? So comfy with the knees. We take a nice deep breath. Expanding and stretching on the sides, softly. Yeah? Keep your knees soft. If you tense your knees, you tense your lower back and you tense your kneecaps and it's like you stop the flow of energy and it's not a good position for your spine. Yeah? Very nice. And then we will go softly toward one side without forcing. Keep the knees soft so you don't force your lower back. Nice and comfy to the side. Keep the knees, yeah? Then expand it. And we go to the other side. And spread. Good. And we will have the hands on the front. We will round it. Bring in the chest and the belly in. Comfy. And we will open, pressing into the feet. So check if you can press with your feet, but without tensing your legs. Yeah? So you press, you push down, but keeping your knees soft. And imagine that you collect that energy coming into your feet, through your body. We bring the shoulders away and we can put the hands on your glutes, or if you can, catching your hands. And just open your chest, your solar plexus. Very nice. And from there, we will separate a little bit more your feet, comfy. We will open your arms, comfy with your knees. And imagine we take like a starfish position. And we spread here. Again, your knees are soft. Yeah? Expand and recover this idea of receiving from above the violet light and from beneath. From the roots, all the energies, all the color of the chakras, yeah? Red, orange, yellow, green, pink, turquoise, indigo, and the violet light. And imagine that you are allowing yourself to be trespassed by all those energies. Go and then relax. Yeah? We will put the feet a little bit more closer now. And from there, rolling your shoulders. Bring your hips out a little bit. Yeah? So tilt your hips back out. We will put the hands on your thighs and slowly, keeping the knees bending, we will go really softly to a forward bend. So your hips are out. Your spine is nice and open, like arching even. Yeah, and you let your belly approach your thighs. And then you allow your belly, your solar plexus, your chest, your head, your neck, your arms to relax. Doesn't matter where you arrive. You keep your knees bending. You keep your head relaxed, your neck, your shoulders. Soften, soften, soften. Just let go. And imagine that you are letting go everything. Your physical tension, your stress, your worries. Everything is leaving your body now, your mind, your heart. Doesn't matter how much you are on the floor, how much your forward bend is, yeah? The more important part is that you are letting go. Keeping your knees bending to protect the lower back. Let your neck soft, your head soft. Good. Well done. We will put the hands on your shins or on your knees. We will look up, opening your chest, lifting your head, but keeping your bum out. And from there, we will put the hands on the floor and we will go to the floor, to child pose. Yeah. So we will use those pillows or the bag that you have, Ursula, or the bolster if you have. Yeah. So knees comfy, open. We put the pillows, a starting point will be your knees, yeah? If you already know this pose, you go. And again, if you need a cushion for your bum or your feet, you put it there. Yeah? If you feel, we will go to lying down in this position on the bolster, and we put one cheek on the bolster. If you feel that it's too low, you can put another pillow or a block or a blanket beneath to lift it so it's more comfortable for the head. Yeah? If at any point you feel that the knees are too much here, you can lie down on the bolster on your belly, but keeping like your legs beneath, yeah? So your lower back is protected here, yeah? It's not touching. Cool. So confident, you can put your blanket, yeah? So again, we will imagine the bolster is like a continuation of the roots to make it more comfortable for you. So surrender there. Spread a little bit your chest, your belly here, your neck. Yeah? We want the spine nice and long. And then when you relax your arms, relax your shoulders. Yeah? Check that your shoulders are not too much into your ears. Surrender. And imagine that you use the pillow or the bolster for support, not only your physical body. Yeah? Imagine that you are taking a beautiful support here for your emotions, for your heart, for your mind. So let yourself relax in that support. It's like a metaphor, the bolster here. Yeah? Represent the support of the planet to us. Yeah? So imagine the planet beneath offering you a beautiful hug of love and protection. And in this position, we can imagine with that violet light reinforcing or creating a cocoon around you. If you're ready, know about the cocoon, just reinforce the idea. If it's the first time, imagine that you are creating with that light a cocoon around you of violet light that will create like a filter around you so you are protected and safe, and the violet is transmuting and transforming any energy that need to be transformed in your body, in your mind, in your heart, in your energy field, but also will transform any energy that is coming your way. Yeah, like a strong protection. And just allow that energy to keep cleansing, yeah, washing over you, surrendering, releasing, letting go. Each breath out, surrendering. And little by little, we will move and we will put the other cheek on the bolster. Yeah? We will turn the head softly. And we will put the other cheek and we will surrender there. Letting go. Keep imagining this light forming that beautiful cocoon around you, really strong.
soften your shoulders, soften your chest, your belly, your hips. Then really gentle, you can use your hands on the floor as a support. We'll start to go up slowly from the bolster. And we keep the position.
Now we keep the pillows as you have it. And if you didn't put anything on the top, put another pillow or another blanket folded or a block, yeah? So it's a little bit high and we will turn around, yeah? And now we will relax on your back, yeah? Now, if you feel that the cushions or the back that you have are not comfortable for the lower back and you prefer to lie down directly on the floor, that's okay too, yeah? Now the legs, so your hips nice and close to the bolster or the pillows, your legs could be crossing, your legs could be with your feet together open, and you can put extra support here beneath the thighs, yeah? Or you can bend in or you can extend it, yeah? Put your blanket again. So we lying down on your back, taking your time. Nice and comfy. Let the legs, you check now. So before, try to have a comfortable position. Again, if you feel that your lower back is suffering here, just go maybe flat on the floor. Yeah? Or you can put a soft blanket just behind your back. Yeah? And put your blanket or your things over your chest, yes, well. And start to let go there. Yeah, so once you find your position, again, start to connect and reconnect with your breathing. Check that you are nice and long on the bolster or on the floor, grounding your hips, lengthen your spine, lengthen the back of the neck. Bringing the chin more toward your chest, yeah? Open your arms nice and wide. And allow your body to surrender there. Now in the child pose, we focus on letting go and to release, yeah? In this one, we will focus on receiving. So nice and comfy, start to imagine again the roots connecting with the energy of the planet. And imagine that the roots goes really deep into the very center of the planet, the very core. Yeah? The core of the planet is steel, iron. So imagine that you, when you breathe in, you are absorbing that strength, that huge, powerful strength that you can imagine the core of the planet has. Yeah? So breathing, absorbing that strength, that power. And surrounding the core of the planet, there is a layer of fire, yeah? Fire energy, you know, the lava that is goes into the volcano. So imagine that your roots are connecting with that powerful energy as well, and you take the red light from the fire. So imagine the iron, the steel energy plus the fire, the red light entering into your hips, your perineal area, your pelvic floor, your legs, your feet. A beautiful red light.
And with your breathing, you allow that energy to cover your whole body, to the whole self. And you can even tinting the cocoon around you, yes? So you transform your cocoon in a beautiful red color. You still have your violet around, yeah? The wall of the cocoon is violet. So let that red light pass through your body and through the cocoon. And then the roots will focus on the orange light of the fire. Imagine orange now, the light coming up. Yes, through your lower back, through your hips, through your belly. And then expanding through the whole of your body, the whole of yourself. And filling the cocoon with this orange light. And then imagine beautiful yellow light coming from beneath, from the planet, going into your solar plexus, filling your body and yourself with a beautiful energy, filling the cocoon as well with that beautiful yellow light, a warm yellow light, and then the roots will take a pink light from the planet, the energy of love, unconditional love of the planet as a beautiful mother. You receive that energy from the Mother Earth, receiving that energy into your body, into your heart, feeling the cocoon. And then this energy will be transformed in a color turquoise. Again, it's passing through your whole body and it's focusing on your neck, on your shoulders, on your throat. And imagine this light empowering your ability or your strength to communicate your needs, your desires, your creativity. And then this light will be transformed in a beautiful indigo color that will connect you with your wisdom and your intuition, with your higher self. And imagine as well the cocoon. And you keep receiving that violet light from above the cocoon. So now you can imagine the cocoon and your body filled with these lights. Yeah? You can imagine all those lights at once, or you can imagine one, or the one that is coming to your mind in this moment is the one that you need. Again, don't worry if you don't visualize the color properly. Just have the idea. Yeah? And just let those lights like dancing inside you and in the cocoon. And just allow yourself to be transformed, to be cleansed, to be filled with all these energies that will balance your physical body, your emotional body, your whole self. Imagine that you are being balanced, you are being cleansed, you are being nourished, replenished, filled with everything that you need. God. And then we will combine all these lights. Yeah, remember are the colors of the rainbow. Yeah, all the chakras form the color of the rainbow. So imagine those, all of these energies now combining themselves in one beautiful white light. And imagine that white light filling your body completely and the cocoon. containing by that violet light around. And let this white purifying you, cleansing even more. And open your arms, open your heart, open your chest to receive. And then slowly, as you keep visualizing all those wonderful energies there, all that white light, you start to bring some movements to your feet, to your hands. We'll take a nice long stretch, soft. And we will fall slowly to the side, bending your knees, putting your arms as a support for your head. And then slowly coming up to a sitting position. So we will take the bolster or the pillows now from beneath, and we will do our last restorative. Yeah, so you have the pillow there or the block, so we will lying down on the floor with your knees bending. Yeah. Good. So for a moment, you bend the knees, bring the lower back close to the floor, nice and grounding your hips, like tilting a little bit forward so you can feel the lower back there. Spread your arms, yeah? And we will have the bolster or the cushion or the pillow or your block beneath your bum, yeah? So we'll put the block there, nice and comfy. Beneath your hips, your lower back. And we soften there, yeah? Take your time, find a comfortable position. If you feel it's too much with the pillow, you put your blanket, maybe a little bit roll. So you have, we want the hips a little bit higher than the rest of your body. And we will focus in this position on the emotional body, that is your lower back, your belly, all the internal organs there. That's the sitting of the second chakra that is managing the emotional self. So imagine that support of the bolster or the pillow or the block beneath, supporting your emotional self. Let yourself be supported, and imagine the planet giving you a big hug here. Embracing you with a big loving hug. Completely safe and secure. Yes, so allow your body to relax completely there. As you relax more on the pose, you can spread your spine, the back of the neck, nice and long, open your arms. Relax deeply. Surrender. Each breathe out like we did at the beginning. Each breathe out, you let go, you release. God. And then, if you like, yeah, if you prefer to stay with this position, you stay, okay? But if you like, we can lift in one leg, lifting the knee first. So you feel, you check that you are comfy on the hip, and then you can lift in the foot. So the leg up, but comfy with your knee bending. And you can stay with one leg up, relaxing on the position. letting go deeply there.
There is no forcing of the leg here.
Just set the leg up. This is a beautiful position for increasing the circulation on the physical aspect of the leg. But we are still working on the second chakra. And the first, of course. So you are receiving support for your emotional body and also for your physical body. And just let go there. Let go completely. As you keep relaxing, you can expand more. Yes, so spread your back, your shoulder blades, your arms, the back of the neck. Good. Now really gentle, you can lower slowly that leg. Really gentle. Put it back on the floor. And we will lift in the other knee first. Comfy. And then your leg. Comfy. Relaxing. Let your body surrender there. Letting go. Using each breath out to let go. Feel the support on your hips, on your lower back. And keep imagining the huge support that you're receiving from the planet. And then slowly, really slowly, check if we can lift in both legs. Softly, knees comfortable. If it's not comfortable with the legs up, you can bend the legs and cross the legs like knees to the chest. Yeah? If you can, keep the legs for a little bit there, expanding, so we keep helping with the circulation. And let your lower back keep falling back toward the floor, your shoulder blades toward the floor. Expanding your arms as you let your body relax there. Expanding the back of your neck. Softly, you can keep still, or if you like, you can move a little. And then slowly bend your knees. And you can cross your feet if you feel more comfortable and keep the position. You can keep your arms expanding, or if you like, you can catch your knees or your thighs. Yeah. Softening. And then slowly. We put the feet on the floor. Soften. If you need, you check. Yeah? Sometimes maybe you feel that you need to expand the legs on the floor here to stretch your legs. That's depending on your lower back and the height of your block or your pillow. So if you feel comfortable, you can expand your legs, your groins, but keeping the belly in. If not, just bend the legs, yeah? So don't force this opening. You check how you feel. Good, and then slowly bringing your legs back, and we will take the block or the pillow from beneath. Relax your lower back on the floor. Stay for a moment there, feeling your lower back on the floor. You could remember that in this position, when you come back, you can feel or a hot sensation or a cold sensation on your lower back. And then we bring the knees and we soften. And we will go to a spinal twist, really soft. Yeah? So we bring the knees to one side, we open the arms and we relax. Nice and easy there. Breathing deeply, allowing your spine to have a gentle twist there. Softening your belly, your lower back, softening your arms, your shoulder blades, your neck, relaxing. Just let go. And then slowly, slowly, we move to the other side. Softly. And then slowly. We will go here to Shavasana. Yeah, so you can lie down nice and flat, or you can put your pillows beneath your knees to make your lower back more comfortable. Yeah, so find your position, have your blankets, your pillows, anything that you need. I will sit so I can lead you. Now remember, if you want to keep your Shavasana for longer, you can stay there, no problem, yeah? Good. So, nice and comfy. Allow your body to start to settle. Nice and cozy. Good. Very nice. Focus on relaxing first your lower back on the floor. Yes, that's your center. Ground your lower back. Let your spine spread here. Lengthen in the back of the neck. So we want to relax in a really open Shavasana. Let your legs expand as well over the floor or your pillows. And again, start to focus on your breathing. So we recover the idea that with each breath, you are receiving energy from the planets through the roots that are going up into every part of your body. And we recover the idea of the violet light coming from above, bathing your cocoon and bathing you completely, inside, outside. And once you place this idea, we will receive an extra energy that will enter into your body, into your feet, yeah, the sole of your feet. And this light is an energy of unconditional love. It's a pink light
So imagine this light ready there to enter into your body, will fill your body, will fill your cocoon, and will overflow your cocoon, so it's bathing your whole house. Yeah? So imagine this energy there in the sole of your feet, ready now to enter into your feet. It's moving now into your heels, passing through the sole of your feet, your toes, the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your thighs, and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades. Imagine that energy moving through your arms, into your hands, your fingers, and then passing through your wrists, your elbows, your shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly, allowing your body to soften completely, to relax completely on the floor, and go deeply inside now, and relax, relax, relax. Slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to head back into your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet. Moving your fingers, your toes. Moving your head side to side. And bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. And from there we roll toward one side, bending your knees. And we go to a sitting position, crossing your legs. And now have a nice big breath. And remember that you can have with your breathing the power to connect every time or anytime that you need with the energy to recharge or to release or both. Now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to join this class today. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me.